we've got Melissa Miller parked sideways in turn number one. I believe that is going to bring out an early yellow flag. No, it is not. She gets that car going, and we will stay under green. Aaron Rawitzki leading the way, and they're going to come up on Melissa Miller in that 93 in a big old hurry. It's time to commit. Aaron Rawitzki going to the high side. Dave Bailey to the low side. Look at Ryan Beagle, as well as that 21 machine, who I believe is Jason Fontaine, showing up as Reezy George in our scoring monitor, but I believe that's racing Jason Fontaine in the 21.
Rolling on the bottom, but he's got Bailey and Beagle right around him.
Watching drivers just fight for the inside of the racetrack. Everybody wants to be down against the concrete. Ryan Beagle about a lane and a half off the bottom, and then there's Aaron Rawitzki, who's just fallen out of the top five, but he seems content to run up in that outside lane in that beautiful black number four.
As we watch Jason Fontaine try and hunt down Dave Bailey, of course, Bailey is the multi-time track champion at all three of the dirt tracks here in Southern Ontario. So he has battled Fontaine many nights at Humberstone as they battle for those championships.
Wow.
Trouble on the front straightaway. One of them got straightened out. Was that Lampman into Lampman over there? No.
No, Steve Shaw did a full 360 coming off a turn four, and it looked all by himself, lost it. And I don't know if he flattened a tire or what happened. Donnie Lampman was up to speed, had nowhere to go.
10 laps in, 10 to go here with the Thunderstock feature. Dave Bailey out front and leading over Jason Fontaine, Ryan Beagle, Rob Murray in the battle for fifth is Logan Schwedick and Trevor DeBoer.
If you remember one of our TV races earlier on this season, Dave Bailey got beat by Trevor DeBoer right at the end of the race, and he kind of mustered a smile and said, well, if I'm gonna get beat, you know, I like racing with Trevor DeBoer, he's a buddy of mine. I think tonight he's out here for one thing only, and that's to win this race. I don't think he'll be as gracious a second place finisher tonight if something is to go wrong.
If there were team owners, it might have worked there, but Bazine can't close the door on Bailey for his teammate Jason Fontaine, and Fontaine now slips by the other Burger Barn 21.
Like seeing double down into turn one with one lap to go. Dave Bailey by about five car lengths pulls out of turn number two, streaks down the back straightaway.
Double cheeseburger. Here we come out of turn four. Dave Bailey with control of the field comes down to it. Double checkers out. Dave Bailey wins it over Jason Fontaine with a great run.
Double green flags in the air from Kyle McKenzie. We are underway.
Johnny Miller, the Iceman, leads the pack. Here comes Jesse Costa, though, working the outside line. He is going to go side-by-side with Jerry Hill down into corner three.
Impressive start by Hannah Farrell, the Hurricane, in that white and red Oakwood Transport Lucas Oil-sponsored machine. Matt Barnum just got around her for the four spots, but she got really a nice run through one and two that first time around.
Down the hill comes Jesse Costa. He's cleared third and fourth, and now is trying to work the outside line on Johnny Miller. You wonder if Jesse Costa watched some of those B mains and saw how good the top side is. Costa back up on the top side with Farnham right there. Top two have broken away a good distance away from Hannah Farrell. A solid third place run right now. Liam Martin, they're in position four, and Brad Heron with a good top five outing for him.
You saw a bit of a rooster tail on the turn number three off of Jesse Costa's number 52. That means he got up over the cushion, up into the loose clay. That could have been a bad scene for Costa. Now he'll drive the car in on the middle of the racetrack where there's no grip. As he slides up the track, Matt Farnham drives to the inside. Give Matt Farnham the lead.
Farnham in that seventh machine has the top spot, but Costa digs back on the bottom. They're wheel to wheel, and there's no racing room coming out of the corner. How will they all fit? Farnham threads the needle and puts two lap cars between he and Costa.
The truth of the matter is they would not all fit. That's a big advantage to Matt Farnham as Jesse Costa's lost a lot of ground. Still plenty of laps left, six laps to go.
Meanwhile, Liam Martin has been able to scoot by Hannah Farrell into the third spot, put Farrell back to fourth, and Brad Heron still there in fifth.
White flag, Hannah Farrell's got one more lap to try to get Liam Martin back and wind up on the podium. That would be a huge score for Farrell as she eases around the outside of Blaine Barrett to the inside of Liam Martin for third.
Off a corner four, checkers in the air for Matt Farnham. He'll pick up the victory. Second will go to Jesse Costa. who will take home third. It looks like it's going to be Liam Martin.
Green flags fly. We are underway.
We rumble down into corner number one, and it gets busy quick. Here comes Greg Panunte. He was fast in the heats, and he's out to the lead going into corner three.
Dylan Davidson got a nice run off of turn number two. He's up in the third spot, but Brad Rouse to the inside of him. He's going to take that third position. Ah, not so fast at the stripe. Davidson wins that battle at the line. One lap complete. Panunte trying to get that nose to the inside. This is a big moment for Greg Panunte. If he can clear this lap traffic without having to stray from his line, that'll be a huge deal for the driver, the number 99.
Driver that likes lap traffic the most, I think, is Dylan Davidson. He's caught the top two now. He's right there on the back bumper of the 18R. Brad Rouse working off of corner number four. Panunte leads at the line over Rouse, Davidson, Chevalier, and James Michael Friesen. As they get into the corners, the differential closes, and Rouse trying to work it down the hill off of corner four. He's right there.
Well, Greg Panunte having to go to the high group, well, just off the bottom, to try to get around the slower traffic. Panunte goes around, clips Chad Chevalier. Chevalier clips James Michael Friesen. Oh, my goodness. What an unfortunate turn of events for Greg Panunte in the 99. Hard on the throttle off of turn four. I like the run Friesen got as Davidson bounces off the 12 of Chevalier.
Here comes Brad Rouse digging down on the inside. James Michael Friesen on the outside as they go into corner number three, side by side. This time by, we will see the white flag. One more trip around for the race of champion sportsmen.
Beautiful crossover for James Michael Friesen coming off of turn four. Rouse going to try to return the favor in one and two.
Down the back stretch they go for the final time. JMF will lead them into corner number three in a car up and over on its side. And that will bring us under the red flag.
Okay, we're hearing the next flag after the white does end the race, so I believe we do have our top three, James Michael Friesen, Brad Rouse, and Dylan Davidson.
They rumble, bubble, stumble down into corners one and two. Christopher Bell and Scott Kruder will lead them down the back stretch for the first time.
Good, clean start. A little bit of contact off of turn number two in the middle of the pack. Drivers trying to find their groove. We got one car, looks a little bit slow in three and four, back up to speed now. It was Jason Barney in the 87. At the front, it's Christopher Bell over Scott Kruder and Jordan Thomas. And Kruder looked like he aggressively slowed up as Jamie Turner in the 11 peels down onto the infield. Looks like his race will be done. Not sure if Kruder had a problem or what he might have been reacting to.
Kruder, Smith, Dylan Westbrook right there, second, third, and fourth. Westbrook in the mix in this one here tonight. Troubles up on the high side, I believe, once again, Jim Hoopinen.
Hoopinen way up out of the groove on turn number four, comes to rest on the outside of the racetrack.
Then the last restart, work it down the banking. Wow, what a line by Christopher Bell.
That was aggressive. Cranked it hard to the left, down the hill, got a run, but not enough to keep Mark Smith from flooring the slider into turn number one. Mark Smith to the lead, Christopher Bell going back to the inside. He'll slide up in front of the 55 to take the lead back.
Bell has it, but Smith not going away. The Sunbury, Pennsylvania driver digging down deep on the inside line. Here he comes up in front of Bell. He'll put the slider on. Bell now will look back down low, going down the back, stretching into corner three.
Jordan Thomas with a big restart in that 79, jumped up into the third position. Dylan Westbrook trying to get it back. Another slider by Mark Smith on Christopher Bell. What a battle at the front.
Out in front, it's Smith over Bell. Bell gets a great run off of two. Down to the inside he goes. Down to the bottom in corner number three. Now he'll pull the slide jump. But Smith now down, back to the bottom. He'll try to return the favor and does.
Crossover move by Mark Smith as they reach the halfway point of this 30-lap Northern Summer Nationals feature event.
Down the back stretch another time. Mark Smith, he's been so close to victory here, yet has not been able to do it. Christopher Bell wants to keep it that way. Around the outside, Smith shuts the door at the line.
What great finesse by both of these drivers. Absolute understanding of where their race car is, where their competitor is. Showing a little bit of respect right now, as I think as the laps wind down, you gotta throw that out the window at some point. They might erupt there in turn number four.
Wow, you don't get any closer than that without wrecking as Tony Stewart now pulls the 14 off. What a battle at the front. Bell on the outside takes the lead back.
Christopher Bell has found something on that exit of turn two where he's able to find some grip and really get a good run. But don't look now. Here comes Dylan Westbrook in the 47X.
White flag comes out for Christopher Bell out of Norman, Oklahoma. One more lap. Can he hold off Mark Smith?
To the extreme outside in one and two, he's still dealing with traffic, but he's been dealing with it almost all race long.
Off of corner three and four, looks like second time is a charm. Ring the bell, Christopher Bell gets the win here at Oswego Speedway.